The chip shortage still complicates the 2022 auto forecast. Hello, I'm Kevin Hunter, the homework guy, here for my first show in 2022 with the amazing Elizabeth. And by the way, thanks, Liz, for the great coverage you did on the show here during my hospital stay.
Sure thing.
The global microchip shortage has cost the auto industry millions of lost vehicles and billions in lost revenue last year. The latest estimates have the problem lingering through the first half of 2022. Here are a few reasons why the chip shortage is the bane of the auto industry.
First of all, let's compare the production timelines of cars to chips. A new car plant can go from groundbreaking to start of production in 2 years and reach full capacity in as little as 6 months. The same process at a chip plant takes up to 5 years. And while it takes only 15 to 30 hours to build a vehicle, it takes 5 months to produce, package, and ship a chip to an automaker for the installation in a vehicle.
That's a pretty big difference.
Yeah.
And the chips in cars have to be built to last longer and work in extreme weather conditions, unlike how they get used in something like a cell phone that gets used mostly indoors and is replaced every year or so.
So here are the actual production numbers of the STM microelectronics factory in Agrate, Italy. It takes 3 months to produce a silicon wafer. This facility produces 2,000 8-inch wafers a day, and each wafer contains up to 1,000 chips. And this plant runs 24/7, so it's not like they can just add more shifts and get more chips.
The big question is, what's being done about it? We've mentioned Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company before, and that they're building a new $12 billion facility in Arizona. But it will be 2024 before this plant actually gets chips and wafers into cars. Samsung, which is based in South Korea, will invest $17 billion into a plant in Texas. And Intel itself is building a $20 billion expansion in Arizona.
So clearly, building new facilities is not going to provide immediate relief of the automotive chip shortage. The other trouble with production of any kind is workers, and skilled and trained workers for the chip production. Automation will be key for this industry as well.
With all of these delays, the auto industry has to do something different. They have to find a way around this. We think car manufacturers will continue to eliminate options that require chips. Several did it this past year, and they'll do it again. Others focused on selling their top trim levels, their most expensive cars, to get more bang for their buck, or rather, for your buck.
So our advice to keep and fix your current vehicle still applies for at least the next 6 months, if you can wait that long.
Hopefully you can. All right, if you appreciate our video today, consider giving us that great big thumbs up, and please always remember to comment on our videos and share them with your family and friends. Comments really matter because they help boost our online visibility and lead others to great Homework Guy content.
The entire Homework Guy team is here to represent you, the car buyer, and that's what we love to do.
Thanks everyone for coming back. We'll see you on our next video. You guys rock. I'm Kevin Hunter with the amazing Elizabeth.
We gotta go.